Quarterfinal action continuing here at the 2014 Hobart International. The last of our quarterfinals for the day session about to get underway. Monica Niculescu and Estrella Cabeza Candela. First meeting between these two players. Should be a very interesting match. This in the bottom half of the draw. The winner to play the winner of tonight's match, Gabin Muguruza and Kirsten Flipkins. Sunny at 23. It's a beautiful day for tennis here in Hobart. It's been pretty light. It's starting to pick up a little bit as the afternoon goes on. But certainly very comfortable for the spectators today. Very happy after seeing the top seed, Sam Stosur, win through to the semi-final. Well, both players out on court. Let's find out a little bit more about them. Estrella Cabeza Candela reached the top 100 for the first time in 2013, and her best result on the WTA Tour was a semi-final appearance at the tournament in Palermo. With 8 ITF singles titles to her name, she won through qualifying here and scored a first-round win over Italy's Karen Knapp in the opening round, and a second-round win over defending champion Elena Vesnina. Please welcome from Spain, Estrella Cabeza Candela. Monica Niculescu finished inside the world's top 100 for the fourth straight year in 2013, winning her first WTA title in Brazil. Also last year, she made the semi-finals of two other events and the quarterfinals here at the Hobart International. Already in 2014, she reached the quarterfinals of the tournament in Shenzhen and hasn't dropped a set to get to this stage of the tournament, beating 2012 champion Mona Bartel in the second round. Please welcome to centre court from Romania, Monica Niculescu. And our umpire for this match from Germany, Isabel Seyfried. So first meeting between these two players at WTA level. We've seen a lot of first up matchups between players here, and wonderful effort with Cabeza Candela to win through qualifying and then make the main draw and make the most of her opportunities. Straight sets win in the opening round, and then Vesnina was forced to retire in the final set with a hip injury. So through to this stage of the tournament, be good for her ranking. Certainly heading into first Grand Slam of the year. Build up confidence, play plenty of matches, get good match play, feeling good out there, and get ready for the Australian Open. Ranked 114 in singles, Cabeza Candela. Play qualifying that Vena was talking about for Niculescu.
1 minute.
Lost in the second round there. Been as high as 95, so cracked at the top 100. That was back in May of last year. Certainly a wonderful opportunity, but it'll be a tough match. We know Niculescu is very much a unique player on the WTA Tour. And you'll see why if you haven't watched her match in a few moments' time. Be part of the conversation at Hobart Tennis.
Ladies and gentlemen, this qualifying match will be played the best of 3 tiebreak sets. Monica Niculescu won the toss and elected to receive. Time. first set.
So ready for a start. Estrella Cabeza Candela to serve first. I'm going to replay the point. Idea the forehand slice that Niculescu uses throughout her matches. Got great variation in her game. What a slice. Flatten out the ball. That gives you an example of everything that Niculescu has from the back of the court.
Lofty.
Niculescu also involved in the doubles event here in Hobart, playing with Clara Zakopalova. And their opponents tonight, Shuko Aoyama and Miki Miramura. Easy put away. Niculescu will give you a lot of different spins on the ball. We'll flatten it out from time to time. And just being able to hold your concentration. Pressure by Cabeza Candela. Slowly making her way to the net. Didn't rush. Just two goods. Good power from Cabeza Candela in this opening game of the match. There's the change-up from Niculescu. He's flattening out the ball. Thank you.
Oh, great running from Niculescu. Almost got there. Had to cover a lot of ground so far in this game. Still a good crowd in at the Domain Tennis Centre this afternoon. People making their way out just to get some refreshments. Mirza Candela holds in the opening game of the match.
First game.
So Monica Niculescu to get us back underway for the opening game. It took a long time, that changeover of court. Mirza Candela has had plenty of success on the WTA Tour, despite where her ranking sits at the moment at 114. Five-time quarter finalists. And make it six for today. Just once made the semi-final. Plenty of ITF singles titles. And get an idea again, this is a similar sort of thing to what happened in the match with Bartel yesterday. Bartel was forced to change her game. Her style of play, see, just blocking the ball, forehand slice from Mirza Candela. It's a change up. On the second bounce, just forced to hit up. Bounced three times before she got to it, trying to get a racket under the ball. First ace for the match. Niculescu holds. Intriguing matchup, this one. We're one game all in the opening sets. Tonight, Garbiñe Muguruza and Kirsten Flipkens, the second seed from Belgium, will be in action. And they will play the winner of this match. Capesa Candela, the important thing would be to keep the ball nice and deep. Just keep Niculescu on the back foot. Reading the play from Caveza Candela. Niculescu frustrated with herself. You can see just that slight move forward. Know that Niculescu will just play that short slice. Pressure again. This is a good thing about the Caveza Candela game. Just taking time. Have to be very patient against an opponent like Niculescu. Just wait for the right opportunity. A wonderful rally. Well done by Niculescu. Both players, in fact. the movement around the court. Here's a Candela just picking up the lob and to throw it up herself, and Niculescu put it away. And here, Monica Niculescu and our fix mic working super hard at the moment for every single point. Again, finds the line. Break point. And they're forced to come forward. He's getting right around that ball. The break of serve. Niculescu leading 2-1 in this opening set.
Niculescu leads by
Right on the line. That was right in front of the lines person. Not going to be overruled. Good volley by Kaveza Candela. I said to the umpire, what is wrong with you? Trying to place it on the line to get that ball to drift away. Just not quite finding the mark. Thank you. Just missed. Good pressure again by Niculescu.
15-30.
Content to use a slice from the back of the court, but also can change it up, use it as an approach. Second ace.
30.
Yep, straight onto it. Nice change up again from Niculescu. Flattening out the ball. And see there. Giving it a little bit extra. Game point for 3-1. This pump from Hevesa Candela. Just having to think her way through this match. That's wonderful slice from Niculescu, really cutting down the ball.
Advantage, Niculescu.
And that's loose from Cabeza Candela. The deep serve for Niculescu, consolidating the break 3-1 in this opening set. Wonderful touch from Niculescu at the net.
Lofty. Thank you.
Great pickup. As well inside the baseline. Just managed to get the racket to it.
30.
See, Gamesa Candela, good position at the net. Probably thought she'd done enough. Just struggling with the pickup there. We should have thought about changing, just flattening out the ball on that approach. A little bit extra for Gamesa Candela to get back. Gamesa Candela is taking a bit too much time. The umpire straight onto it. We'll replay. That's better. Gamesa Candela holds. Niculescu still with a break though. 3-2 in this opening set.
13-15.
So Niculescu holds serve, still with that break, 4-2 in the opening set. Niculescu earlier today, Clara Zakopalova 6-4, 7-5 over Alison Risk. And Sam Stosur 6-3, 6-2 over Bojana Jovanovski. One match to come tonight, Gabin Muguruza of Spain will play Kirsten Flipkens, the second seed from Belgium, for a spot in the semi-finals. The last minute. It's a tricky time for Niculescu. Breeze has picked up a little bit. It means it's in that slice. She can't afford to float the ball. It will drift wide. Wow. A very interesting drop shot. Niculescu, a little bit of disguise on it, just getting it over the net. Well done. Did well, good speed to get to the net. There's a change up. Yeah, plenty of height over the net, Niculescu, for that drop shot. Yeah.
Mirza Candela holds, but Niculescu still with the break, though. Four games to three in the opening set.
Ball change, please. Niculescu leads by four games to
be very hard playing against Monica Niculescu to find any sort of rhythm. Mirza Candela just struggling at the moment. That's clever again. Niculescu has done that so well, so patient to get to the net. Just making sure of that by moving forward. Be careful she didn't touch the net. So Niculescu holds five games to three in the opening sets.
Niculescu leads five games to three.
Wonderful day in Hobart. Crowds have been flocking in. We had rain a little bit earlier in the week. Now it's just wonderful. Going to be warm to hot tomorrow. 30 degrees Celsius predicted. Nice again. Just that pressure keeps building up. Niculescu, she's able to move Cabeza Candela around the court. Wonderful again. There's the variation. So just chipping the ball around using slice to flattening things out. Candela getting a high percentage of first serves into play, 80%. Just over half of those points and half on the second serve. Oh, well done. It's a great volley from Cabeza Candela. Picking it up off her shoelaces. Right there. And Niculescu, full stretch, brings up set point. Great set from Monica Niculescu. 44 minutes to take the opening set, 6-3. And I'm not sure what she was signalling to the umpire there. As to whether the trainer's been called to court. So, looks appeared to be a shoulder problem for Niculescu. But we'll wait and see. The trainer won't be too far away. This is the only match happening right now at the Hobart International. So the trainer will be on their way. And understandably, Cabeza Candela will have her coach out on court. So a bit of a wait. We'll see what happens with the trainer.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Nicolescu is now receiving a medical timeout.
So the assessment period's been completed and Monica Nicolescu will have 5 minutes to get treatment on that injury. Her shoulder appears to be the problem. So we'll see how it holds up after this to whether she can continue in a really strong position. 6-3 in the opening set. But now we wait. So after that long injury timeout, Monica Nicolescu will be serving first to try out that shoulder. Candela will have been watching that injury timeout and will be doing everything she can to make Nicolescu stretch for the ball. So 40, 50. Signs of that shoulder problem that Niculescu had an injury timeout for. And the change of set. Game points in the opening game. Mesa Candela just looking to pick up the pace. Try and take some control of this match. Nicely finished. Just caught on the back foot, Niculescu.
Deuce.
And see, way out of court. And that's the patience that Cabeza Candela is showing. Had to wait for the right ball, then put it away. Back to Deuce. Be frustrating for Cabeza Candela. An injured opponent, but still not able to make any inroads. In the opening game of this second set.
First game, second set.
Oh, now we've got the opportunity to meet another of our tournament directors, our junior tournament directors, and Henry's wandered up and joined me. Welcome along. This is almost going to be a very short stint for you if we, Monica had have retired from her match, but lucky she's still out there playing.
Yeah, it's good.
So what are some of the things you've been getting up to? Across this week?
We've been doing quite a bit. We've helped out a lot with the courts and the events like Kids Day and the high tea and things like that.
Cabeza Candela serving. And there are 15 of you, as we've found out throughout the week, all working very hard behind the scenes. Now, have you had the chance to meet some of the players?
Yeah, we have. Not getting into deep conversation with them, but...
Yeah, who's been your favourite player, though, that you've met along the way this week?
Probably Alison Risk.
Yeah.
She was very nice.
We were talking about her a little bit earlier, and she tweeted a photo of her in a picture with some of the tournament directors. Did you get in that shot?
No, but...
Yep, she said, just trying to find the tweet now, some of the sweetest volunteers or something along those lines.
Yeah.
Which was nice of her.
Oh.
Who else have you had a chance to meet?
Haven't really met anyone else into kind of well enough to say, yeah.
Kimeza Candela holds. One game all in this second set.
One game all.
You play yourself, tennis?
Yeah.
Yeah. How's your 2013 gone?
Yeah, it was pretty good. I travelled a bit.
Yeah, where'd you travel to?
Around the state and to Melbourne and a few other places.
Was that for the showdown?
Yeah.
In Melbourne?
Yeah.
And how did you go?
I just played teams.
Yep. How did the team go?
I think we came seventh.
Yep. Is that the first time you've played in Melbourne?
No. I've played in a few of the previous years as well.
Very nice. Do you enjoy heading up to Melbourne each year to play?
Yeah, it's good.
Who's your coach down here?
David Tunbridge.
Been working hard in the off-season. A bit hard being a co-tournament director and also having to go through your coaching sessions as well. And Niculescu goes wide. You're still getting time to get out on the court and have a hit during this week?
Yeah, I've had a few chances in my breaks and stuff, yeah.
How many days a week, or how many times a week, do you actually practice and go into squad?
It's probably not really squad, it's just more hitting one-on-one now.
Yep.
But probably 5 times a week, maybe.
Better hitting from Kaveza Candela. Small opening to get a break in this second set. We should point out too that can actually come up and play on these courts, and you know, a lot of training sessions and squads and all sorts of things. Tournaments happen here right throughout the year. Nice variation from Niculescu. Good pace. Move it to 30 all. Which court do you enjoy playing on? Do you get an opportunity to play out on centre court much?
Yeah, we do. It's a nice experience playing on there, especially in tournaments.
And how many tournaments have you won?
I'm not sure.
Oh, I have to count them. Normally players have that information ready to go. You'll need to practice that. Your style of game, do you think you could play like Monica's playing at the moment with the slice forehand?
No.
Just wide, good pressure from Kaveza Candela. There's the break of serve, 2 games to 1 in this second set. Really interesting match here on center court. Did you watch Sam Stosur earlier today?
Yeah, I did.
What'd you think?
She played pretty well, yeah.
Thinking she can win tomorrow?
I hope so.
Yeah, I think that's the right answer. I think that's what everyone's thinking here today. So what's happening after the tournament? Are you going to play some more tournaments yourself?
Yeah, I am. I'm heading up to Launceston.
Very nice. In fact, I think are all the co-tournament directors heading up there?
Yeah, I think most of them are, yeah.
I think that's the next sort of step with what's happening. And then what about goals for the year? We talked to the players here in this tournament about what they want to achieve. What about for you?
I'm hoping to get to the showdown again this year.
Yep.
To teams and individuals.
Excellent. Yeah, certainly individuals. Have you played individuals before?
Yeah, not last year, but the year before.
Okay. Yeah, it was a fun time of the year in Melbourne, at Melbourne Park. It's called the December Showdown, and 12s, 14s, 16s, 18s events happening, plus the Australian Open wildcard playoff. So there's plenty of activity. And the good part is it's all free, so you can go in and wander down and watch Henry play. Don't even need a ticket. Iveza Candela with a break in this second set, leading 2-1. Nicely done again from Niculescu. What about a prediction for this match? You had a bit of a chance to watch it.
I think it might go to a third.
Certainly, I think the fans might want it to go to a third set as well. Trying to put some heavy topspin on the ball, Niculescu. She'd be a tough opponent, wouldn't she? Niculescu, all the different spins on the ball. The slice, then occasionally flattening out the ball. Nicely done. Iveza Candela can't afford to let that ball float. Because Niculescu will be onto it. She's a very clever player, crafty player. Just missed.
Yep.
She can't believe it. With the right setup, there was positive play. And you can hear her just into the back of the effects mic, just working so hard. Put so much into every single ball she hits. Just missing the edge of the line. Breakback point for Niculescu. Bring this back to 2-2. An hour and 7 minutes on court already. Oh, well done. Great scrambling at the back of the court from Niculescu. Two games all. What did you think of that, Henry?
That was good running, yeah.
Very good running. Now, do you have a particular game style? Do you model it on one of the top 10 players in the men's game?
Not really, no.
Who's your favourite player?
I like Songa.
Yep. Playing pretty well at the moment.
Yeah, he is.
The charity event, Roger Federer and Friends last night. Did you get a chance to watch it?
I did, yeah.
Pretty good match. Went to three sets. Just wide.
Lofty.
Still talking to her team on the sidelines. Nicely finished. Right on the line. What does your coach tell you about playing in windy conditions? Henry, we've seen the wind come through here. It really does blow up here in Hobart, up here at the Domain Tennis Centre. We're up on the hill. Gusty breeze. How do you play it?
Try to keep the ball low.
Nicely done. Again, just patient, Kaveza Candela there. You know, if the players are looking for advice on how to play this particular court, you're the man. You've got the experience to be able to help them out. Players across the river, comes back up the hill. There'll be a little bit of cover from this end of the court. Niculescu is serving now. And nicely put away again, just standing at the service line. Kaveza Candela with another break point. You might have three sets after all. Break of serve, Kaveza Candela leading 3-2 in the second sets. Well, been great having you in, Henry, being a part of the coverage. We'll let you get back to work because I know the tournament director, Mark Hanley's standing just watching what you're doing and sort of pointing at his watch saying, get back to work. So well done.
Thanks for having me.
So consolidating the break, Camisa Candela, 4-2 in the second set. We're just switching tournament directors around from the junior tournament director to the actual tournament director, Mark Hanley, who's been running around all over the place over the last week. Nice to see you.
Good to be here, Pete.
Just familiar surrounds in the commentary box. You're used to this.
What a stunning day,
yes,
Pete. I don't think we'll ever get used to this. This is fantastic.
Yep. Well, let's talk about ticket sales, because the crowds, particularly over the last couple of days, have been amazing.
Yeah, we're going very, very well with ticket sales. So the final particularly, we've only got a couple of hundred left for that. So that's selling extremely well. The Friday night session as well is also strong. And there's been a particular interest over the last couple of days with Sam playing during the day. So we've been close to capacity, but not quite. So there's still room for people to get on up and cheer on Sam in the semi-final tomorrow.
Has the schedule been confirmed yet? So I suppose we have to wait for these matches to be completed.
We do today, considering we've got Zakopalova, who will play against Sam, and also yes, Monica in the doubles. So I suspect that if Monica wins her singles, then the chances of two singles in the day is more likely, considering they have to play the singles before the doubles.
Yep.
Be very dependent too on how they perform in their doubles tonight. So the schedule for tomorrow is going to be quite late, I suspect.
Nicely done again. Great scrambling work from Niculescu. Couple of game points. Well, certainly there's been a lot of buzz and interest in Sam coming down as a top seed. Different preparation for her. She's been on the front page and the back page of the local newspapers here, and it's brought people through the turnstiles.
Yeah, the interest has certainly been there, but it's also put the spotlight on Hobart itself. There is a lot of media around Sam and her preparations ahead of the Australian Open. We know that her performances there haven't been great, and they've been well documented. And it's fantastic to see that she's getting some matches under her belt. She's getting some wins to gain the confidence. And she's getting some good wins in tight situations. So she's handling the pressure and the expectation really well here in Hobart.
Well, there have been plenty of different things that you've done this year, most notably with the site, and we can see the boards at the back of the court as watch them with the players there, and the WTA signage, the backgrounds in black with the Hobart International. Looks quite smart.
Yeah, it's there's a few things that we changed. Over the first couple of years, we let the event go and had a really good look at it, and then did some soul searching straight after the 2013 event on what sort of things we could do to be able to strengthen the brand of the tournament. And the first one was the marketing campaign, which we think is great, and we'll look to build on the Hobart International brand now with great support from the government and Marilla as well, still on board. The second thing was we were really hungry to get some superstar players to Tasmania generally, or Hobart.
Yep.
And we were fortunate enough to be able to get Martina Hingis for an exhibition match. Venus Williams entered the tournament, and unfortunately she had to withdraw because of a performance in Auckland, and what a great run that was. And and our national number one, Sam. So it's taken the pedigree of the event to another level. And the third thing was how we make that spectacle and experience affordable for people to come and enjoy it. So we changed the business model, made it cheaper for people to come to the tennis, $20 to get in as the entry fee, $5 for kids, and I think that's worked really, really well.
Yeah, well, full stands pretty much yesterday and today. It's has paid off. I noticed too, walking around Hobart, the stickers of the former winners just leading up to the courts, and as you walk up the hill, slowly in my case, all the former champ, well, some of the champions who played, both former and also current players who are entered in the draw, we've got their pictures up as you make your way down. Make your way up, I should say.
And I guess that was important for us too, to be able to get a link between the City Hard and the stadium. Just getting people to know that there's a tennis tournament, a major international tennis tournament with some fantastic players in it, just up on top of the hill. And Judy Murray, Andy's mum, who's the Fed Cup captain for Britain, likened it to the Hansel and Gretel walk. And that's just been another addition as well that's been important for us. And to be honest, it feels like a new event, Pete.
It does.
So, which a lot of work goes into it behind the scenes year round to be able to put on the spectacle, and we know how important the events are around Brisbane, Sydney, Hobart and the Hotman Cup to allow the players the opportunity to be able to get some good quality play, to get some good quality facilities ahead of the Australian Open.
Again, Niculescu just putting the pressure on. Meza Candela has had to get a lot more balls into play than one she would expect. Niculescu chasing everything down. But it certainly has that a certain feel about it, this tournament. It's a very relaxed feel, good opportunity for the players to come down, get some good matches, get good practice, and just take their time before they head to Melbourne.
Yeah, and it is genuinely low-key. The eyeballs aren't on them as much. The closeness of the city and the closeness of the accommodation and the infrastructure that we have on site, including the player gym, has been important for us to be able to use that or utilise that as a carrot to entice players to play. And clearly, Sydney, the major attraction is the prize money there. And hence they got 5 top 10 players in the world. So we can't compete on that level of prize money, but what we can do is look at the other things that mean a lot to the players and the players' experience and really focus on those things, doing the little things well, the 1%ers, to ensure that the players are getting everything that they need.
I'm not sure if you saw the tweet from Alison Risk a little bit earlier today, talking about the tournament directors, junior tournament directors. And she's been having fun with them over the past couple of days because they've been so helpful.
Yeah, we've had 15 of those kids who have just done a tremendous job through the week of the tournament. But also in the lead up too, they've been a really good help to me, and hopefully now they can start to relax a little bit and enjoy the tournament, and take pride in the fact that they've contributed significantly to the success of the event, because without them those 1%ers that I was talking about wouldn't have been able to get done.
How big can the tournament get? What's the plan beyond this year? I know we're sort of jumping ahead a little bit.
Well, I'd love to see the stadium packed out every session. That's the goal. So I think we've still got a lot of room for improvement in that. I think that our branding will stabilise. I think our ticket pricing will stabilise. So that leaves the attraction of the star players as the one variable. And if we can continue to bring those elite players to Hobart, the players that compete week in, week out on a global stage, then it means that we can build on what we've created this year. So, which I think has given everybody that new sense of motivation to be able to deliver this event for them, for the players. And our volunteers, some of the volunteers have been doing it since the first tournament back in 94. And I'd be interested to get their feedback as we go. But they're the glue that holds the entire event together.
30-15 here for Niculescu. The break back. Important stage of the match. Struggling again there, Niculescu, trying to cut under the ball. Well, 30 or 4 all. The tournament is 21 years old this year. Is there going to be a big party?
There won't be a big party. We did a...
Speeches?
We did a celebration last year for the 20th.
Yep.
Peter Johnson from the WTA was here and recognised that fact. So... I guess, in essence, there won't be a party, but, hey, we've got those things we spoke about before, Sam and Venus in the lead-up and the new branding and the former champions that we had that continue to come back here, like Mona and Elena and Zheng Ji. And our Aussies have, done a great job as well with Storm.
Yeah, what a great performance yesterday.
Storm and Olivia and Sam, of course.
And Casey Delacqua.
And Casey was unlucky as well.
All the Australians made it through the first round, into the second round of the tournament.
Yeah. So hopefully we can welcome them back next year.
So all you're saying is for the 21st, all you're going to get is that giant key that people are going to sign as the tournament director.
I probably should do that, shouldn't I? Please sign this as you're coming into the gate.
Yeah, exactly.
You were here. Yeah.
Well, one of the other things, too, that you actually started yourself personally was scanning patrons into the venue at the gate behind the media centre. And now getting the players on board to do that.
Yeah, it's important to as the guests come in, they we're always looking for something different and to enhance their experience. And if they've got someone there at the front gate that's there to welcome them and say hi and enjoy the tennis, and then it just makes them feel a little bit special. And I was up there this morning, whilst I didn't have the ticket scanner in there. I got locked in the ticket box this morning, so I was getting a little bit claustrophobic in there. But that was my intention to get out there, but got stuck.
Literally. Yeah, they didn't have to get fire brigade to get you out.
No, they didn't have to get fire brigade, but we did have to get the screwdriver and pull the handle and the locks off. There's been a few players up there this week, and we'll continue to do those little things because, we can. It's a tight-knit community. It's a It's a small venue. We've only got the women here, which means it's not the proverbial jungle when you've got both genders here. So it allows us that flexibility to do something different.
Great fighting here from Niculescu.
Juice.
Just about see the finish line. All games all and Juice. Well, certainly the weather is always a talking point. And the first couple of days weren't so great, but we've had fantastic weather. Going to be hot tomorrow by Hobart standards, 30 degrees. And then a cool day, but sunny on Saturday for the final.
Mm. Yeah, look, that was the one thing that we really were hopeful of at the tournament, knowing that we've created a product for delivery, ready for launch. And that product launch in the first few days was could have gone better. Namely, Martina's exhibition match and the weather that intervened there, and the title defence of Elena as well on the Monday night was rain interrupted, and she had to come back on Tuesday to play. So I think that the only thing that's out of our control is the weather.
Exactly.
No matter how much work you can do, it's still there. So we were hoping to start the event off with some really good momentum. That didn't eventuate, and of course, when it rains, it becomes a domino effect. There's players' interests, there's spectator interests, and then it becomes a scheduling nightmare to be able to get matches through and complete them.
Yeah, well, we played on an extra court to get those matches through.
We had to get a fourth court up and running, which meant our court services team were under pressure. It meant that our ball kids and our lines people were stretched to the max to be able to get that up and running. Our young TD stepped in and did a ripping job to get that, get those four courts together and fit for people to, or for the players to play on. And of course, once Tuesday hit, we got a bit of blue sky, and away we went. So we've been able to keep the momentum going. Sam's performances have certainly helped that. And hopefully she can continue to perform on the centre court here at the Domain. And we finished the event on Saturday afternoon, looking back on what was a very successful event, and how can we make it better next year.
And you can see, even from this low camera angle, the view, and that view will be going all around the world from tomorrow, the semi-finals and the finals, live to plenty of countries watching the backdrop.
Yep.
As our colleague Eleanor Preston described it, it's like Monte Carlo with sheds.
That's a fair call too.
Now, so, I haven't been to Monte Carlo, but I've seen the television on the TV.
I suspect the beach is a little bit closer to the court than Monte Carlo, but the mountains and the water and the court just... It's a great spectacle on days like today, particularly.
Yeah, it's such a clear day. See, for miles through the Derwents and the big cruise ship as well. We've had that docked here in Hobart for a couple of days during the week.
Yep. Your token cruise ship always gets in the postcard pictures. Wow. Nice hands.
Well, nice hands from both players. Again, Niculescu playing defensive. She does that so well. Just keep the ball back in play. Now, before we let you go, we should talk about quickly some other things happening. After the Hobart International, there is plenty of tennis after the Australian Open around Tasmania, but also here in Hobart at this venue, the Fed Cup tie, Australia and Russia.
Yeah, we've got 39 days of tennis straight somewhere in Tasmania, Pete. 108 teams competing in the Australian Seniors Championship starting on the 13th. So,
are you, you're not quite seniors level though?
35 plus is seniors, so I actually qualify, but I'll be getting my hands dirty somewhere for that.
With a racket in your hand?
Huh?
With a racket in your hand?
No, I won't be competing. Then the individual championship, which is an ITF Grade 1, which is the highest level seniors event in the country. So. These events rotate yearly around the States, and it's Tasmania's turn to host. Follow that up by the McDonald's Burnie International, which is a $100,000 event now. It's been upgraded. The women's side of it has been upgraded to a $50,000 challenger, so that's now equal of the men up there.
It's and a beautiful Burnie Tennis Club. They do a great job up there.
Yeah, and it's our biggest, our single biggest facility, Burnie, with 16 hard courts up there. So the domain here has a beautiful centre court, but a mixture of surfaces.
Five games all now in the second sets.
Then we go, the women's tour continues down to Launceston, so that's been upgraded from a 25 to a 50,000 as well. So we'll be looking to attract some of Australia's best players there. And
well, certainly it's handy because the players who are sort of ranked maybe 60-plus and are still looking for more tennis can stay in Australia.
Yeah.
Some of the players who may be competing for Fed Cup teams can play that week in Burnie first before coming down to Hobart, so they can get some more matches in if they don't feel they've had enough preparation.
Yep.
So there's plenty of options, and you do get the best of the Australian players. It's part of the Australian Pro Tour, which makes its way around the country across the year. But also the, some great international players who stay on and enter these events.
No, we've... Eugenie Bouchard won Burnie a couple of years back. Arina Rodionova's been a champion up there as well. And Oliva Rogowska has also been a champion up there. And Launceston, although it's in its infancy, this will be its third year. Storm Sanders broke through in Launceston in 2013. But, yeah, I... be interesting to see how Fed Cup captain Alicia Molik assembles the work schedule of her players, knowing that the team will come into camp on that Monday of Launceston, and whether there's going to be a few of the young ones that are going to have a run in those events. Certainly in Burnie, I suspect that a few might get a run. But we're looking forward to having the Aussie team in there in what's a... what's a very important tie for us, which I think we've got a team that's capable of doing very, very well in the team competition.
Oh, certainly. And to play here again, Tasmania and Hobart hosted a tie, first round tie against Italy. A couple of years ago. So certainly the general public is aware of events out there and world-class events too.
Yeah. Yeah, I think they're, you know, the girls have all played here. They're getting used to the court. Sam having success, Casey having success, Storm having success, Casey having success. Ash Barty, the only one missing a course, but was a wild card until injury got the best of her up in Brisbane. So Alicia Molik's serious about...
oh, yes.
..beating the Russians here on home soil.
Pleased to announce, too, that Nicole Bradke will be in commentary with me for the next couple of days, playing in the tournament in Adelaide, or the event in Adelaide at the moment. Not happy with the call. Break points, though, for Cabeza Candela.
And again, we might go to three sets, Pete.
Yep.
There's a story of last year's tournament. A few 7-6s in the thirds.
Well, a couple here, particularly with Sam Stoza.
It's happened yesterday as well with Storm and Sam.
Break points. Nicely taken. Gee, doing well under pressure.
30-40.
One of the more unique styles on the WTA Tour, Monica Niculescu.
She is, isn't she?
But it works, it and does. It works effectively.
Takes the pace off the ball.
No, it's going to be put away. Miss hits. Here's a Candela, though, gets the break. 6-5 in this second set. We'll let you get back to it, right? Busy day, but wonderful tournament. Always love coming down and being a part of it here, and it's going to be a wonderful couple of days to finish it off. Well done.
Thanks, Pete. Always a pleasure to have you here as well, mate. Fantastic. Thanks.
Mark Hanley, the tournament director of the Hobart International.
First service.
So Niculescu gets That's a break of serve, and we go to the tie break. Still not sure which way this is going to go. Really interesting match. Niculescu fighting back. 1 hour and 45 minutes on court. Spot in the semi-finals up for grabs, and the winner to play the winner of Gabi Muguruza and Kirsten Flipkins tonight. Cabeza Candela to hold her nerve. Early into this match, first meeting between these players. Taking a little while to get used to each other's game styles. Finish. Again, just depth of shot from Cabeza Candela, making the difference. Well done. Again, that variation coming into play. The slice and then really flattening it out up the line. Got it. Gee, that's clever play. Importance of following in the drop shot.
3-2, Niculescu.
Well done. Play that high ball well. Got a position, quite balanced. 3 points all.
3-all.
Just questioning the call. And she went to the chair, Niculescu there. Match has been in progress, 1 hour and 50 minutes. From Cabeza Candela.
4-3, Cabeza Candela. Balls, please.
Again, too big on the lob. 5-3 now for Cabeza Candela in this tiebreak. Putting himself in a very strong position in this tiebreak. Now set points. Estrella Cabeza Candela.
Cabeza Candela.
On her serve. She's got it. We're off to a deciding set. Cabeza Candela taking it 7-6. Exciting third set coming up.
Candela to serve. Game, Niculescu. First game, final set.
Fighting again from Niculescu.
59.
Worked hard to get the break of serve in the opening game. got it. Getting a good read of that ball heading into the backhand corner.
15-30.
Desperate to get the break back, Cabeza Candela here. Trying a few different things, just trying to find a way through. Managed to do it in that second set after a few close calls. That forehand slice that's doing the job for Niculescu. Always forcing Cabeza Candela to hit up. That's wide.
Yeah,
great start in this final set for Monica Niculescu.
Niculescu leads 2-0.
Already been a big tournament for Estrella Cabeza Candela. Coming through qualifying to make the main draw, winning a couple of matches.
Yep.
Had a wonderful week. Still very much in this contest. Oh, well done. That's clever stuff. Not often that you see the players in a rally just working between the service lines, but that's what they were doing. Oh, nice pickup. Cabeza Candela holds, but Niculescu with the break. 2-1 in this final set.
Niculescu leads by 2-1.
New tennis balls for Monica Niculescu, serving at 2-1. Serving. Just the fourth ace for the match for Niculescu. One double fold, 66%. First serves going into play, winning 58% of those. Desperate for an easy service game. Hold to love. To continue that confidence. On the line. Great work. Ibiza Candela throwing up the lob. Was more in hope than anything else. Finish. Cruising along, Niculescu. Ibiza Candela putting a bit of pressure on now. Went for it and got it. Sent her to that so many times through the match. Three games to one in this final set. Coming up tonight, Garbine Muguruza will play Kirsten Flipkens. Niculescu might be up three games to one in this final set. And have a break. This match by no means over. Seeing Ibiza Candela work her way into the match. Dropping the first 6-3. Just trying to lift the pace. Trying to get things on her terms. She has control. Oh! We're going to replay again.
First service.
Great fighting, Kaveza Candela. Staying in the contest, Niculescu 3-2 in this final set.
Niculescu leads by
Oh, very precise from Niculescu, going for depth. And then forehand corner, seeing good variation. Look at the opportunity to have a look at a hitting map. Be going both sides. Just didn't pick it up with the double hander.
59.
That is a tricky volley to hit, particularly up at shoulder height. Did well, Niculescu, in the end. Kaveza Candela had a couple of opportunities to try and get past. White. Struggling a little bit getting that ball up the line. on that side, Kaveza Candela, across this match. Well done. Frustration from Niculescu. It's a good sign for Kaveza Candela. Trying to break down the Niculescu game. And in the end, that was just a smart shot. Didn't overhit it. Just dropped it at Niculescu's feet and did it to the backhand volley. Shakier of the two. Better. Right idea, Kaveza Candela looking to go up the line. Put more pressure on that backhand volley. Niculescu up to the challenge. Niculescu hangs on in that service game. 4-2 now in this final set. Coming up tonight, Gabi Muguruza of Spain. Another qualifier through to the quarterfinals. Be playing the second seed, Kirsten Flipkens. That match coming up later on tonight. Still, I think momentum notionally with Niculescu, but Kaveza Candela has played a tough match. Really tough. Now, big opportunity for Niculescu in this service game. Love 30. Oh, it has been a high intensity, high energy match from both players. They've had to cover a lot of ground. Been a lot of interesting rallies. Just needing to be careful with the wind, that slice, so the ball doesn't drift away. Just a couple of unforced errors at bad times for Kaveza Candela. Niculescu, now the advantage in the game, was pegged back. Hey. Well done. Great serving from Kerveza Candela, 69% into play, winning 64% of those points. Took a little bit on the second serve, but a high percentage of first serves into play, and another game point. And holds under all sorts of pressure. Kerveza Candela hangs on. Niculescu still with the break, 4-3 in the final sets. Oh, nicely done again. Back foot this time for Niculescu.
15.
Trying to find a way through. She's found the corner as well. Let's get the feeling Kerveza Candela is hanging on by her fingernails in this match. It's very much on the racket of Monica Niculescu. Hold for 5-3. Put pressure on the Kerveza Candela serve. Willing herself to the line, 2.5 hours on court. Thank you. Oh, dropped late. Break back points for Cabeza Candela. Hasn't had an opportunity in this set. Overall, 3 of 7 for the match. And there it is. We're all square in the final sets. 4 games all. Remember, we do play a tiebreaker if it is 6 all. Miss. Frustrating miss. But goodness, Niculescu continues to work hard at the back of the court. Test of fitness for both of these players. Dennis Niculescu just changing things up again, just trying to get into the net. Her breathing in the effects mics. Works super hard today. Cabeza Candela has worked hard too. Now under pressure on her serve. An even serve volley. So she's trying different things too. And the right wide, follow it in. Try and take that time away from Niculescu. Don't give her any opportunity. The second one. Well, it has been an entertaining contest. finally puts away the volley. Again, with multiple opportunities, Kaveza Candela, but playing the volleys up the middle of the court. Then working on the angle. Game point. Got it. Kaveza Candela, 5-4 in the final set. Niculescu will be serving to stay in the match next. So Monica Niculescu needs to hang in. It's in a really good position during this final set, but some great work from Kaveza Candela. Sees her up 5-4. Just wearing down Niculescu. It's been smart play from Kaveza Candela. First to get used to the Niculescu game, then to keep moving her side to side, wearing her down. It's a good volley. Fatiguing. It was a very good idea to come to the net. Well done again. Niculescu changing things up, getting to the net, putting the pressure on, forcing Kaveza Candela to come up with the big shot. Thank you. So an extra bit of pace that Cabeza Candela is able to throw in. And coming to the net, being aggressive. It's a good play. Great shot at this stage of the match. Match points.
34.
2 hours and 40 minutes on court. Monumental struggle. All of a sudden we have match points. And she's done it. What a great way to bring up the match. Estrella Cabeza Candela. A wonderful performance. Had to fight back in that final set to win an epic here on center court. 2 hours and 40 minutes. A really interesting match. Niculescu fought hard, ran a long way, but in the end, the Spaniard is through. The qualifier is through to the semi-final. And we'll play the Garbine Muguruza or Kirsten Flipkins in tomorrow's semi-final. 3-6, 7-6, 6-4. 2 hours and 40 minutes on court. And very happy, Estrella Cabeza Candela. Coming up tonight will be Garbine Muguruza, another qualifier from Spain, in action against Kirsten Flipkins. Estrella Cabeza Candela is there, very happy. Look at the smile on her face. And Monica Niculescu, another good performance here in Hobart. Another quarterfinal for her here. Estrella is downstairs with Matt.
Kind enough to join us. Well done, Estrella. It must be a great feeling to be in the semi-final here in Hobart.
Yes, I'm so happy about the tournament, about the match. It's so hard, this match, and all the tournament, all I play. And I'm so happy to play tomorrow semi-final.
You started in qualifying earlier this week, so you've now had six matches here in Hobart. What do you think of your opponent tomorrow? Obviously, they're playing tonight. You'll play either Kirsten Flipkins or your fellow Spaniard, Muguruza.
Yeah, this is two great players. So good players.
Well, best of luck. We've loved watching you here in Hobart. You're competing very well, and it was another fantastic match against Niculescu this afternoon, and we can't wait to see you in tomorrow's semi-final. Please congratulate Estrella Cabeza Candela from Spain.
Yeah, wonderful win in three sets. 3-6, 7-6, 6-4, 2 hours and 40 minutes on court. And her opponent for the semi-final will be decided tonight, Garbine Muguruza of Spain, to play the second seed, Kirsten Flipkins. That's our match for broadcast tonight. And we look forward to your company a bit later on from Hobart.